I rise like the sun sometimes, but then I fall. Like a black moon, I rise when the night falls. When the night falls, the mic calls, so listen, it's the ultraviolet reason. Keep me rising on the mission. I rise like the sun sometimes, but then I fall. Like a black moon, I rise when the night calls. When the night falls, the mic calls, so listen, it's the ultraviolet reason. Keep me rising on the mission.
And we're off. What's up, Hype Beast? It looks like it's finally happening. Anthony Davis, one of the best players in the NBA, has officially requested a trade from the New Orleans Pelicans. Now, I didn't think this was going to happen because I thought Anthony Davis was going to be too cautious with his image to actually trade, you know, off of a team, because you get a big fan backlash whenever you say you don't want to play for the team that drafted you anymore. And I thought Anthony Davis was going to be too cautious to go ahead and take that L. But today, early in the morning, we found out that he said to the Pelicans, first of all, I'm not signing any extension that you put in front of me in the offseason for sure. Doesn't matter if it's over $200 million or not. I'm not signing it. And in fact, I would also like to be traded to a team that has the consistency and the stability to compete for championships. Now, the timing is interesting because Boston, unless they trade Kyrie Irving for Anthony Davis, they can't really do trades right now. They have contract issues or whatever. They wouldn't be able to pull off an Anthony Davis trade unless Kyrie Irving was involved. So there's that. Anthony Davis has, since the season started, has been rumored to want to go to LA to play with LeBron James. And LeBron James has been kind of low-key wanting to trade for Anthony Davis. I think when they started this season, I think the deal that Magic put in front of LeBron was that, hey, we're going to see how the young guys work, and if we like what we see, then we'll keep them. But if we don't, then we have an Anthony Davis trade that could be worked out. Now, obviously, LA has an Ingram problem. Not that Ingram, you know, is a bust or anything like that, but I think the idea was to see if Ingram had something that would make him elite, whether that was a defensive presence that would make him elite, or whether it was like a secondary scoring presence that would make him an elite player. And what we found out is that it was neither. At least at this point, it was neither. Even with the long arms, the 7'3" wingspan, he hasn't shown to be that great of a defender. He's shown to be a good defender, but not like a Paul George or anything like that. We haven't seen that from Brandon Ingram. And then offensively, he struggled at times this season pretty bad, and at times he's, you know, he had one game I think so far this season we had 28 points, but usually it's like 16 to like around 22 points or whatever that you can get out of Brandon Ingram. And since LeBron has been hurt, you needed him a lot more, and he hasn't really been able to come through. Lonzo Ball is probably going to be a casualty from this, and I thought Lonzo Ball has been playing, before the injury, was playing some very good basketball. It's not always efficient shooting. It's not always good three-point shooting, but he showed progress shooting the three-pointer, and I thought he did some very good things this season. But it looks like whatever he's done, it may not have been enough, because it looks like they're gonna probably need to include him in the trade. And then Kyle Kuzma, who's been balling out this season, hasn't been super efficient, but has still been balling out. The effort's been there, the point production has been there, the improvement on three pointers, even though he's shooting a poor percentage, he's taking a lot of them, so it's kind of hard to take. I think Kyle Kuzma has been playing very good this year, but looks like he's definitely gone, because in any trade, he's the true value in any trade. Brandon Ingram is still like a potential. You like the wingspan, you like what he could become, but it's not so much about what he is now. You have somebody like Lonzo Ball, you still, even though you know that he's a good player, you still think that he can get better, but it's still not so much now. Kyle Kuzma is the only guy who has the goods now that you can believe in. So that's gonna be interesting to see how they get that trade done. But yeah, the Lakers have been pretty bad since LeBron has been out, even though they showed, you know, some signs of being a good team when LeBron was there. But it's over. It looks like the project is over. It looks like they're going to really go hard for Anthony Davis. And Anthony Davis is gonna has gone hard already because he did the thing that I wasn't sure that he was going to do, which is request a trade out of New Orleans. Let me know what you guys think down below in the comment section. Was Anthony Davis right for requesting that trade out of good old New Orleans? Or should he stick it out and just play his whole career with one team? Be loyal. All right. Let me know what you guys think down below.